Hey everyone, what's up? My name's Dustin, and I'm a developer and technical evangelist here at Treehouse. Today I want to show you how to create this simple animated hamburger menu for mobile navigations. It's pretty easy to set up and only takes a little bit of HTML, CSS, and just a little bit of JavaScript. I'll be building this from scratch, so if this is something you want to learn how to do and follow along, feel free to open up your favorite text editor and follow with me. Let's get started. So as always, the first thing I'll do is create a new folder on my desktop. I'll name it Hamburger Menu and drag it to VS Code. I'll get started by creating some files that we'll need. I'll start off with an index.html file, and then I'll create our styles.css style sheet. And we'll need some JavaScript, so I'll create an app.js file as well. I'll get some boilerplate started in our index.html file, and I'll change the title to Hamburger Menu. And then I'll start linking our CSS style sheet, and then I'll link in our JavaScript file. Next, I will open up our project in the browser. And then I'll open up my text editor and browser side by side. So the first thing we can do is just start writing some basic HTML that we'll need. We'll put this in a nav tag, and inside we'll write hamburger menu as a class name for our div. And inside of hamburger menu, we'll create our three hamburger menu bars. All three of these will have the class of ham bar, and each one will have their respective bar top, bar mid, and bar bottom class names. So in the style sheet, we'll just reset our browser's default style sheet by just adding some margin 0, padding 0, and box sizing border box. Next, we can target the body rule. And in here, all we're going to need to do is just write a background color, and we'll give it a light gray background. And next, we can start styling up our nav. So we'll give it a padding of 1 rem. And then we'll give it a dark background color. I'll go with something not too dark, but not too light. Next, I'll give it a display of flex. And since this is the only item in our nav, I'll put the justify content to flex end. And I'll align the item center. And this should push our hamburger menu all the way to the right. Next, we'll target our hamburger menu itself, and we'll give it some styles. We'll give it a height and a width, and I'll also give it a background color of red. And this is just temporary so that we can kind of see what's going on while we're creating the styles for this. So as you can see, it's all the way to the right of our menu. So next, what I'll do is I'll give it a position of relative because the bars inside will need to be positioned absolute. I'll give it a cursor of pointer, and then a padding of 1 rem. Next, we can get started on the hamburger menu bars. So underneath that rule, I'll create a ham bar rule. And this will target all three of the bars. So all three of them will have a width of 70% and a height of only 4 pixels. We'll give it a white background color. And we'll give them a border radius of 25 pixels. We'll position them absolute with a top of 50% and a left of 50%. And the transform will translate negative 50% on both the X and Y axis. And if we hit save, we'll probably just see one bar. And that's because all three are directly on top of each other in the center. So we'll work on that in a bit. We'll add a transition so that whenever we click on our hamburger menu, they'll have a nice transition. So we'll transform 0.6 seconds, the opacity will be 0.8 seconds, and the top will be 0.6 seconds. And you can play with these around to your liking. So for bar top, I will give it a top of 25%. And for bar bottom, I'll give it a top of 75%. So now if we hit save, we should see all three bars, and this should start to look like a hamburger menu. Now, when we want this menu to have the appearance of a clickable X, we'll actually have a class of active set on our hamburger menu. So in order to write the styles for that, let's add that class to the menu now. And once that's done, we can go back into our style sheet and we can start targeting what this menu will look like when it has the class of active. So we'll write a new rule for hamburger menu with the class of active, and we'll target bar top, and we'll transform, and we'll put in the translate negative 50 on both X and Y axis. And we'll also give it a rotate. So we'll rotate this negative 315 degrees. And we'll also update the top to 50% to put it back in the middle. And next we'll target the hamburger menu when it's active for the bar middle. And the only thing we'll do with this one is just make it disappear. And we can do that by just setting the opacity to 0. Next, we'll set up the hamburger menu when it's active for the bar bottom. And we'll do what we did for bar top, but the opposite direction. So we'll do transform, and we'll translate the negative 50% on both X and Y axis. And we'll rotate this one negative 225 degrees. And then we'll set the top to 50%. And now you should see an X whenever you hit save. If we hop into our HTML file and remove the active class, it should go back to just the three bars. And adding the active class back will give us that X appearance again. So if we hop back into our style sheet, we can first remove the red background from our hamburger menu as we don't need that anymore. And now we can start toggling this class in the JavaScript. So let's set up a variable for our hamburger menu. So we'll do const ham menu equals document.querySelector, and we'll put the class of hamburger menu. And we'll write ham menu.addEventListener, and we want to listen for clicks. And when we detect a click on this hamburger menu, we just want to write ham menu.classList.toggleActive. So if you hit save, you should be able to hit the hamburger menu, and you'll notice that the animation will trigger, which is exactly what we want. Sweet, it works. So next in our HTML, let's create our off-screen menu. And we can do that by writing a div with the class of off-screen menu. And we don't need to put any content in this right now just to get this to show. So in our style sheet, let's create a rule for our off-screen menu. We'll write off-screen menu. And in here, what we'll do is we'll set up the position to fixed, and we'll set the top to 0 and the right to negative 75%. And this will make sense in a little while. Next, we'll give it a background color, and we'll go a little darker than the navigation menu. Next, we can give our off-screen menu a height of 100 view height and a width of 75%. Now, by default, this off-screen menu will not be showing, and that's because we have the right set to negative 75%, which is the size of the width. So we'll do off-screen menu with a class of active, and we'll set the right to 0, which should show the entire menu. So what we can do is in the JavaScript, when we click on our hamburger menu, we'll add that class of active to that as well. And I'm just giving a transition of right 0.5 seconds to our off-screen menu. That way we have a little bit of an animation when this rolls in. So let's create a variable for our off-screen menu, and we'll write const off-screen menu equals document.querySelector, and we'll select the class of off-screen menu. And underneath our classList.toggle for our ham menu, we'll do the same thing for the off-screen menu. So off-screen menu.classList.toggle active. And if we save and hit our menu, we should notice it working. But that X should be when the menu is open. So it looks like we still have the active class on the hamburger menu itself in the HTML. So let's just remove that. And now this should work perfectly. Sweet, it does. We have a pretty cool animation for our hamburger menu for our mobile navigation. There are tons of ways to build something like this out, and this is just the way that I like to do it. I think this adds a nice user experience to a mobile navigation for your webpage. I hope this guide helped, and I'll see you in the next one. Until then, have fun and happy coding.